All right. Hi, folks. I'm Bob Schrupp, physical therapist.
Brad Heine, physical therapist.
And together we are the most famous physical therapists on the internet.
In our opinion, of course, Bob.
Today we're going to go over five strengthening exercises that we believe everyone should do. And we're going to show you different ways to do them. But they're the muscle groups that I think, you know, throughout life that you do need to have. And it's also to prevent you from getting into those pain cycles to some extent.
Right. So this is looking in the long run as we age and get a little older. Those of you who are over 50, you kind of know what we're talking about. If you're in your 20s, you probably don't have a clue. But
well, it's really actually important as you get older. Like if you're in your 50s or 60s, it's important that you do these exercises because you're going to lose muscle mass as you age. Just by, if you're just living, you're going to lose muscle mass.
Right.
And every year, it's going to become weaker and weaker.
Right. But the good news is they have proven that people in their 80s and 90s can regain muscle mass.
Absolutely.
With exercise.
Absolutely. And probably in your hundreds, too, maybe, but we just haven't tested too many.
We don't have a large number for a group. Yeah.
I've treated quite a few, though. But by the way, if you're new to our channel, please take a second to subscribe to us. We provide videos on how to stay healthy, fit, pain-free, and we upload every day. Also, yes, please go over to Facebook, Bob and Brad. We're going to be giving away stuff. And right now, we're giving away some positive vibes.
There you go.
Woo, woo, woo. So the five strengthening exercises, the first one that everybody should do is definitely is posture. Some
sure.
type of posture strengthening exercise. For me, you know, one of the best ways to do it is to have the wall anchor and elastic bands because it's just real simple. You can even leave it hooked up like this. And every time you come by it, you can go ahead and just do it, rip off a quick set. And the ones I like, I'll go this angle. Huh,
yeah,
Brad?
So they can see that.
So, you know, what's nice about this, you're actually strengthening the shoulder a little bit too. And you're getting the shoulder in a good position to give you less pain. So you're going to go ahead and you're going to squeeze the shoulder blades back together like this. And I'm, you know, you can do a little bit different. You can go like a field goal. But I usually do right about into the center of the chest here is where I bring it back. And I do a lot of these. I do these almost every day because it's a toning muscle. You don't, have to, you know, it's not one that you have to build up.
And he's look at the wrinkles in his clothing. That means that his scapulas are moving in, and that's the key to getting good postural exercise. You can do this without even the band, and it's going to be helpful. So if you just do this without the band, it's
Absolutely.
A lot better than not doing anything. Much better.
You can do those throughout the day. When you were talking about wrinkles in my clothing, I thought you were talking because I pulled it out of the hamper. But
you didn't iron that today?
It was it's just funny. A joke to Mark Hayden, if you remember me, Mark, he was a physical therapist. Every morning we'd wake up and every time we meet each other at the school, I'd say, did you get that out of the hamper? And he'd say the same thing to me. Did you get that out of the hamper? That was our joke. Okay, next one, Brad. We're going to talk about everybody should do some leg strengthening.
Yeah.
And I like squats. I actually like ball on the wall squats.
Yeah.
It's a great way for, I'm going to show you a number of reasons why it's nice. One, it's very easy for you not to have your knee go past the foot. Where's our...
Oh my gosh, our stick is gone. Yeah, so we're talking about the biomechanics so that it takes stress off of your knees and keeps it on the muscles where you want to have it.
So show the wrong way, Brad.
Okay.
So if he goes way, if you were,
this way,
there you go.
If your feet are too close to the wall, see how, let's put it on this side. When the knee goes past that plumb line above your toe, then you're really putting a lot of stress, particularly on the patellofemoral joint, or just think of the knee being stressed.
Now, the nice thing about squats, ball on the wall, you can do shallow ones. You know, if you're really having some knee pain, you can actually usually do some shallow ones and it won't hurt.
Right.
And then as you get better, you can go ahead and do some deeper ones. I always, you know what the first thing I do with the Brad? I lean over the ball a little bit just to stretch my back a little bit here.
That's so a wonderful stretch.
Now, you can do squats, obviously, too. Just anyway, I mean, you can get up, grab the back of a chair and do some squats.
Right.
I don't care how you do them. Just you got to get some of that leg strengthening because your leg strengthening as you go, strength as you get older is going to go down.
Right.
And you're going to lose that ability to pick things up and you're going to get injured a lot easier.
Right. If you find that you always want to use the elevator instead of the steps, maybe it's because your legs are getting a little weaker. We don't want that.
So next one, Brad, you know, 80% of the population hurts their back bad enough that they actually miss work.
Sure.
So at one time in their life. So we really want to keep your back strong. So you surely do some type of back strengthening.
Yep.
Now, it can be as simple as you could do the type. Well, do you want to throw me that pillow, Brad?
Oh, yes.
Oh, does he want to ever? You know what he's going to do here.
There.
All right. You can lay down on the bed or on the floor, and you can have a pillow below you like this, and you can just go ahead and do opposite arm and opposite leg. It's just a simple back strengthening exercise that you can do here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You want to get a little more advanced, you can go ahead and do the pointer dog. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can do actually a fair amount of these. You can do a good set of 15, I would say.
Sure. Yeah. You may want to start out, if you've never done it before, 5 might be enough. You don't want to get too sore the next day, but it's a great exercise. Covers both sides of the back in a nice fashion that, you know, carries over to daily life.
Now, I'm going to show you a little more advanced. You know, you can actually do kettlebell swings, and we actually did a whole video on this, on how to do it correctly. But you can take a kettlebell. My wife started doing these. She uses a 20-pound one now.
Sure.
And you start with the kettlebell between the legs here, and you're going to go ahead and reach down. And what you're going to do is you're keeping the back straight. Do you want to get our three-point thing?
Yes, I do.
Brad?
Yes, I do.
So we do these a little bit different than a lot of people that are taught. Yeah, I'm keeping a three-point process here. I'm keeping my neck, back, and low back all lined up in a straight line here as I do these.
We do it this way because it takes less stress and off your low back, decreasing the risk for back injury, but at the same time getting a lot of good strengthening in the hips, the hamstrings, the quads.
Yeah, they teach you is they teach, the kettlebell is taught that you actually go down to a platform like this.
Right.
And to us, and you have a hinging here. I think that's too much stress on your back.
Right here.
So we just basically, it's almost a squat. And when you lift up like this, you're thrusting the hips forward, and you're not lifting the arms, it's actually thrusting the hips. By thrusting the hips, the arms go up like this. So you end up going like this.
And look at Bob is really emphasizing this arch in the back. That's a healthy, strong arch. That's exactly what you'll want to do.
And I actually do it with 50 pounds. And to prove it, I'm going to do a few.
Yeah, well, look at the size of that. I didn't even know they made them this big, to be honest with you.
I think they make them a lot bigger than that even.
Well, if people are willing to buy them, they'll make them. They'll look. You need a crane to pick them
up. So
there you go.
Now it's a great back and leg strengthening one.
Yeah, but you don't have to get one of those. We could just work with the ball or whatever.
Exactly. We're just trying to give you options. If you want to do a little more advanced, that's what we would be doing.
Bob just wanted to show off.
I wanted to show off. So, all right, at some point, you're going to have to do some arm strengthening because throughout the day, you're going to be lifting things, and you need to have good arm strength. So we think you need to do biceps and triceps.
Right. And along with this, we're going to get some shoulder. You know, for lifting things in and out of the cupboard, overhead kind of exercises.
You want to get rid of the bingo wings.
Oh, yeah.
You know what the bingo wing is? The lady goes, bingo, and then it flaps.
Oh, Bob, why? So, now, if you've got, you know, you don't have to go and buy a whole set of dumbbells. You can if you want. There's certainly nothing wrong with it.
Yeah.
But sometimes that gets a little cumbersome to find a place to hang them and store them and whatever. You drop them on your toe, it hurts. But if you just, the bands, I think, are a little less expensive, and they do a great job, and you can store them right in the cupboard, you know, right in the kitchen cupboard if you want.
Yeah, and like the, we like the Body Elastic because they're anti-snap.
Right.
And
they got great handles.
They got great handles. Oh, and they come with, you know, like sets of like 5 different tubings.
Right.
So you can double up the tubings and really work the triceps or the biceps. And you can also do it that way.
Right.
Or you can hook it to the wall anchor, which we also recommend.
The thing about those balls, it seems like they always roll the wrong way. So I'm going to hook this one up here. And then, you know, this is another way to work the bicep instead of standing. You can go like this. And this, you know, once you get real strong like bull, you can double up for some of you guys that really want to get that power. Oh, this is, the black bands are like the strongest ones I have. So I'm pretty strong to be able to do this.
Yeah, and Brad did it just the way I do it. I first start off with a single.
Yeah.
And I go like this and I warm it up.
Yep.
And then I go ahead and go to the double.
Sure.
And the thing is, when you do these, it's working your core too.
Right.
I mean,
it's
a lot easier on your joints than the regular weights are.
Right.
The rubber bands are. So, Brad, you were also going to show the triceps.
Oh, the tricep. Yeah. So, with the band, I hook it up above here. And this actually, I do an isometric chair. So sure. I'm getting some other strengthening my quads
at the same time.
And I'm just doing this. You know, if you wanted to double up like this, you can do that. Or depending on, you know, you change band, whatever color you want, the darker the band, the more resistance with these, which is with all bands that I'm aware of. The other, you can do them if you don't want to do the squat.
Yep.
You can just go like this. You can go both at one time. Again, double it up if you'd like. And, you know, these are really nice. Sometimes you can hold the elbow because you don't want this kind of thing happening. We want to isolate that tricep. We are getting some shoulder strengthening and some core strengthening right here. My stomach is working hard to keep me from going, whoa, backwards. So it's a wonderful,
Brad really likes doing that one because he can show off his tricep. Because if somebody asks him, you know, where is the downtown, you know, restaurant? He'll go that way and he'll show off his tricep.
Bob, you're not supposed to tell people I do that.
A little trick. Okay, last exercise that we feel that everybody should do is you really want to strengthen your hip abductors.
The ones on the side, right?
The one on the side, because they're very important in balance. And as you get older, this is the, you know, one of the ones that's going to be the culprits that may be causing you to fall.
Right.
So, you know, a real simple way to do it is actually you can get a chair and you can just go off to the side like this and you can work these off to the side. I'm not dipping like this and I'm not turning my foot either. I'm keeping my toes straight forward as I do these.
So I'm showing them the back view, Bob, as you're showing them there.
Yeah.
So we're not going like this. This would be compensating, or in other words, cheating. We want to keep the trunk up straight. This, again, toes not like this.
And I'm going to show one other way to do it, Brad, with the ball.
Oh, yeah.
You have the ball.
Okay.
So we got the ball. You can just lay on your side like this, and you're going to go ahead and work abduction.
There
like
you
this.
Go.
And you're working more against gravity now.
Mm-hmm.
So these are the ones I do, Brad. I actually do two sets of 30 on these.
I work these. Yep.
And really has made a difference in my running.
Is it?
Yeah. I could tell my legs just weren't strong even though I ran.
I thought maybe you quit running backwards.
Yeah, that would probably help the hamstrings, wouldn't it? So, and obviously, again, you want to do both sides. So,
you know, once if you haven't used the ball and you want to try it, once you get used to it, this makes it very comfortable for a lot of exercises.
Yeah, I mean, you can do these, obviously, I don't want to hit my mic. You can go like this and work these like this too, you know, without the ball.
Yep.
But just a different way to do it. So those are the five, you know, I was trying to think, okay, which exercise do you really need to do? To me, those are the five muscle groups you really need to hit.
Five. Yeah. Did you do this?
Did I? Five.
Well, anyways, one way or another, we just showed you five, and plus a little extra.
All right. Thanks for watching.